Hello everybody, it is me, Dino. I am back after quite the long hiatus. As you see, I was moving homes and was without internet for, we're going on 3 weeks now. But thankfully, the company that we're going with has decided in all of their benevolent grace to give us enough data on a hotspot on a phone that we can use. And hence how I'm getting to you currently.
You know I missed you, babies. I've even grown a little bit of a beard for you. The kitten.
Anyways, being without internet has got me quite a little bit nostalgic, seeing as I have literally nothing to do. And I haven't been without Wi-Fi since I was 13 years old, so I'm going a little bit stir crazy. And I kind of went on a deep dive nostalgia trip from my childhood, looking up videos and ads and products from when I was a kid. And upon this deep dive, a repressed memory has hit me right at the back of the head. Like an absolutely heavy ton of bricks, my head got whacked with the memory of Captain Sunday Sailor. You're probably not aware of this, but I was born in the beautiful country of South Africa. And over there we have a language called Afrikaans. Think of the Afrikaans people as the rednecks of the Cape. They speak Dutch, but it's a kitchen version of Dutch. And in all honesty, their accents do them no favor in making them seem smart. Because if you talk to an Afrikaans guy, he's going to talk to you like this. Do you understand me? Yeah. And obviously growing up there, I was exposed to them quite frequently. I mean, the country is very diverse. One minute you could be talking to a bunch of skull-capping Afrikaans boys. And then the next minute you could be talking to a bunch of Zulu lads. Go down the road, you'll probably meet up with a bunch of Indians. And then just for extra flavor, occasionally you'll get a random Eastern European person from Russia. So needless to say, I was exposed to a bunch of different cultures, whether it be music, food, art, lifestyle, dance, there's just a lot of it. But, and here's the big but, I don't think I'm capable of forgiving the Afrikaans, because they did something horrendous to me. And that was, in the summer of 2008, released the most irritating earworm imaginable. I am by no means fluent in this language, but if you asked me to stand up and sing our national anthem or sing Captain Spandy Sailor, I am going to stand up and put my hand on my chest and sing to Kurt Darren, because the amount of times I overheard that goddamn song just became infectious. It was Gundam style before Gundam style. And now, my friend, it is your turn. Unfortunately, I can't play the original music, but what I can do is play the music video and sing my version to you. Thankfully, before I started making this video, I did a little bit of Googling, and apparently Kurt Darren's a little bit trigger happy on that copyright claim and strike down notice. I think you can understand that I'm not happy spending 10 hours on a video just for it to be removed. So this is the version you're getting. Although, I strongly recommend you listen to the original as soon as you're done with this and you press subscribe legally. Let's show you the masterpiece. Captain. Shit. Captain Spandy Sailor. Captain Sayers Mainer. Darva di son okum. Dar ur di hrson vach saver me. Now, first off, how could you not be impressed with every bit of detail in this video? The absolutely beautiful, beautiful CGI of 2008 shines through. And we can see that budget of 120 Rand gone to very good use with a visual effects artist and a green screen. As you can tell, our protagonist is on the mission to find love. And how he achieves this is by procuring a sailboat and then proceeds to stalk this lovely woman on her island who's just minding her own business when some freak with a telescope and a motorboat shows up, harassing her from miles away.
Captain Spandy Sailor, Captain Sayers Mainer. Dar vardi son khale het se khe se khwaho se vacher mei.
I think the funniest part about this is he's relying on wind power, but there's no wind force whatsoever. He set the sails, but he's got no engine or oars. And the tide's completely calm. He'd be stuck in water. This love journey may look like 3 minutes to you lot, but oh my god, this would be hours of travel. Just so he can ask this girl out that he hasn't met yet on a date. My man's willing to die for Nash.
Ekelad, like a duck duck da. In my dream, shit. Was daar en girl Josie in say me. Daar was in England, while me sees
in bikinis. An animal like Zeus, yay. If I save it, I know that this woman was paid to appear in the video. I'm assuming quite frequently since she's the second main character appearing on screen in multiple different bikinis, as our protagonist Kurt has said. But why did they make her dance like a Charlie Brown character? This is a pigeon. I feel like Charlie Brown, except I'm starting to think that this was a very low budget video. I know, who would have guessed? But I'm also thinking that maybe our singer Kurt was probably the director of this, and more than likely either asked his like wife or possibly sister to do the funny little dance for his video. Either way, they still look goofy as. Captain Spandy Sailor. And up and Rindach uns erlichtet. Dit was nicht ik en jij. Und het mekar in droorga keka. Da was inland for kinders by dunse. Oh shit. En amalike sus jij. Dit was mooier as mooi ver mij. Captain Spandy Sailor. Captain Sayers Mamer. Da war die Sonne opkom. Daar oor die horizon wag sê vir my. Kaptein, span die seile. Kaptein, sê is myne. Daar vir die son, oh god, gelig het sê gesê. And unfortunately for us, that's just about where the video ends. Although some part of me really hopes that that woman, continued her career. She's clearly a very talented choreographer and she needs to open up her own studio. Some hitters with the NPC moves. I feel like Charlie Brown, except I ain't brown. Bitch, I'm green. This is the sound of a lottery machine. The beat kind of. That's all for me. Bye, guys.